这是虎年，这是龙年，明年他们遇到的招生状况一样是跟今年一样险峻。
The number of students dropped by 10,000 in one school year. Today, the academic field is among the first to feel the detrimental effects of Taiwan's severely low birth rate.
过去国小国中，其实会担心的是生源减少，所以老师可能就没有需要那么多，所以会有所谓的借聘超额的问题。那目前这个浪潮已经到高中了，所以现在高中的老师也很多在担心会不会有超额的问题。那我们可以想象，三年后其实就到大学。
The number of participants in the university entrance exams shows just how a low birth rate causes a significant drop in enrollment. Records show that there were more than 58,000 students 10 years ago.But this year, the number has declined to just 25,000.
随着八月份大学分发放榜，我们看到是出现了新三高。所谓的新三高呢，就包含了录取率创下新高，来到了98.94%。另外呢，在缺额人数部分也很高，14,000多人。缺额学校同样也创下新高，来到了51所。
In 2021, only 20 schools suffered from a significant lack of students.One year later, however, 51 schools, including prominent universities like National Tsinghua University, National Taiwan Normal University, and National Zhongxing University, among many others, started suffering from low enrollment. Meanwhile, private universities like Xuanzhuang University are also suffering, as the vacancy ratio exceeds 90%. In particular, Danjiang University saw 1,037 fewer students, while Chinese Culture University recorded a decrease of 2,378 students.
教育部这边应该有整体的一个高教政策，那这个高教政策它要跑在前面，包括哪些可能是未来的一个科系，那有些科系已经过剩了，可能已经不符合了，或者是它应该要转型。那可能不同的一个大学，它会面临到有些A 大学有些 B 大学没有的，那这个部分是不是可以就近科系这边做一个校系之间的一个整合？
虽然教育部也认知到，就是大学招生必须要参看现在社会所需要的人才，但是常在名额的一个整合上面，其实教育部有点是头痛医头脚痛医脚。例如说现在社会跟政府非常的重视资安，所以呢会希望大学这边培养更多的资安人才，可是他并不是想到从原有的现在的资讯科系里面去加重这部分，反而是更增加了很多外加的名额。
With fewer students and tuition fees, private universities are likely to shut down due to high vacancy rates. In the 2020 school year, 44 private universities reported negative balances of revenues and expenses, with a combined loss of 2.97 billion NT dollars among these 44 schools. Its negative growth rate is now at 28.9%.However, experts report that things will likely get worse.
今年啊，大概进入大学的新生大概还是维持在200,000上下。可是你知道去年我们生了多少人吗？只有150,000多。这意思就是说，在十几年之后，哈，我们这个大学可能又要再减掉50,000人。一般来讲，私立大学他们因为比较依赖学生的学杂费，所以你的学生的人数的减少，就会造成。某些私立的大学，他们在整个运作上会产生非常严重的问题。那这些严重的问题呢，就会造成我们高等教育在品质上会产生一些问题。那我们相信，在未来的大概3-5年之间啊，也会烧到这些的国立大学。那到时候可能只有顶尖大学能够幸免了。
As Taiwan's birth rate continues to decrease, schools will need to develop countermeasures to lessen the impact as the problem will likely become more severe in the future. TVBS English News.